Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we will see a topic on noise, one of the variant of noise, which is short noise. What is short noise? Short noise is happened Short noise is due to distinct event of charge carriers. It sounds like a rain. And see, what is the distinct event means? Suppose there are two plates and a current is traveling, passing between the two plates. So that means these electrons will move from this plate to this plate. So what will happen? Whether this electron move completely to this plate or not, that means this event is either happens, or distinct events means the event either happens or not. So there is nothing like off happen, quarter happen, in that way, either happens or not. So some electrons move and reach this plate, or some electrons will bounce back. So this is like, suppose if I draw the transfer of electron, we can consider it as an impulse. Suppose one electron moved, it generate an impulse current. It's not like one, after some time it may like two electrons, and after some time again one electron and three electrons. So impulse of electrons will come based on this charge movement. And so if for a long time it's like average current, we take only average, it's like for long time the current is constant, it feels like constant, there is no impulsive current. These impulses which are generated around the average current creates a noise which is called short noise, which is our short noise. So this short noise depends on what? On what factors this short noise power depends? So once, see, suppose average current is zero, so the fluctuations are zero. If the average current increases, so the fluctuations also increase. So this noise depends on average current. So short noise power, average power depends on average current. And what second thing it depends on? See, the charge carrier, what is the charge of an electron? It is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs per second. Suppose if the charge of electron is 1 millicoulomb, 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3, 1 millicoulomb. So how much it take? That means for 100 seconds, one electron will travel. For 100 seconds, one electron will travel. 1000 seconds, sorry. For 1000 seconds, one electron will travel. Suppose if the coulomb charge is 1. So what will happen? So suppose an current of 1 milliamps is passing. So and this, let's consider the charge is 1 coulomb. So what will happen? I equal to Q by T. So T equal to, for every 1000 second, one electron or one charge carrier is passing. So that means there is nothing, no current, and at 100 second a gigantic amount of charge is passing. So that means more noise. Suppose if the charge of electron is at the power of minus 1000, suppose, or something more than that, minus 1000, then what will happen? So a lot of electrons will pass and the noise disturbance will be less. So it so if charge is more, then noise is more. So it depends on the amount of charge. It's proportional to average current and amount of charge, and we take a proportionality constant equal to 2. So this is the short noise power. This is the power or power spectral density of the short noise. If we further discuss about its spectrum, so suppose there, so this short noise will happen only when there is a distinct event of charge carriers. Like suppose PN junction diode is there. PN junction diode, you have a short noise. Why short noise in PN junction diode? So electron or hole can cross the junction or not, or cannot cross the junction. In a wire, do we have short noise? No. Why? Why? Because wire have lot of electrons. It has a electron cloud, and this electron cloud will adjust itself, and there is no charge or distinct event. The electron cloud moves toward in the wire to generate current. And coming to spectrum, instead of impulses, so there may be some effect of this current, this charge while moving, depends on the transition process. If the electron is near to this plate, then the effect, more effect on this plate, and if the electron near to this plate, then more effect on this plate. So instead of impulse, it may be something like this shape, something like this shape. If we consider this shape as rectangle, so what is the Fourier transform of rectangle? Rectangle Fourier transform is sinc or sinc square. So its power spectral density, one sided is like this and two sided is like this. So it is not flat. So short noise is not flat. So I'm ending this video here. For more such crisp concepts, please follow my channel. Please share, subscribe to my channel, like the video. Thank you.